just as mentioned by the CAS, the Ministry of Agriculture will give its remarks with regards to the launch of the guidelines to embed nutrition security in the COVID-19 national response. Good nutrition is very important during and after an infection. Infections take a toll on the body, especially when these cause fever. The body needs extra energy and nutrients. Therefore, maintaining a healthy diet is very important during the COVID-19 pandemic. While no foods or dietary supplements can prevent COVID-19 infection, maintaining a healthy diet is an important part of supporting a strong immune system. The Ministry of Agriculture has been supporting the Ministry of Health in the prevention of further spread of COVID-19. And I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our first responders, especially our veterinary officers, who have been working tirelessly alongside our health counterparts to implement the One Health approach. Other than the coronavirus, 65% of diseases sending us to hospital today are zoonotic. Our health animal experts have been working hard to prevent similar pandemics from happening, as well as sharing their studies with the Ministry of Health and other experts working toward finding a cure or vaccine for COVID-19. Today, we are releasing the National COVID-19 Nutrition and Healthy Diet Guidelines. I would like to extend, as we do this, a special thank you to our Agri-Nutrition Unit in the Ministry of Agriculture, supported by the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations and other development partners who have worked tirelessly alongside the Ministry of Health and the county governments to develop these guidelines. This is part of our strategy to intensify the war against COVID-19. Ladies and gentlemen, we as a nation must urgently address the following. One, we must ensure that every household consumes a healthy diet during the COVID-19 pandemic. This will go a long way in ensuring that our citizens, especially our youth, who currently comprise the highest number of infected patients, recover quickly if infected. To this end, the guidelines will facilitate, one, a recipe for healthy snacks. Ladies and gentlemen, in recent decades, we have dramatically changed our diets and eating habits as a result of globalization, urbanization, and income growth. We have moved from seasonal and locally produced dishes to high-calorie diets, which are high in refined starches, sugars, salts, and processed foods. Less time is spent in preparing meals at home. And consumers, especially those in urban areas such as Nairobi and Mombasa, are increasingly relying on supermarkets and fast food outlets, street food vendors, and takeaway restaurants. A combination of unhealthy diets and lifestyles that have set obesity rates soaring in Kenya today, our food security challenge, therefore, is comprised of strategies to combat hunger and malnutrition in some part of the country, and obesity and also form of malnutrition in others. Dear Kenya, COVID-19 has called our urgent attention to the general state of our homes and especially that of our kitchens. We now call upon Kenyans to take a proactive approach in radically changing our lifestyles to adopt healthier diets. To facilitate this, the government today is launching a campaign for 1 million households to establish kitchen vegetable gardens. We have issued guidelines to support both rural and urban dwellers with simple technologies for setting up these gardens within the resources available. With the support of the county governments, we will be distributing the kitchen garden starter kits to assist the most vulnerable households who are willing to adopt these through programs called KSAP and NARI. KSAP stands for Kenya Climate Smart Agricultural Program, and NARI stands for National Inclusive Growth Project across the 47 counties. So for Mombasa and Nairobi, which is not included in these counties, we are partnering with the Ministry of Interior and to distribute through the Nyumba Kumi platform, and also the Ministry of Devolution through the Social Safety Net platform. We therefore call upon the more abled household to take up this initiative and use guidelines to set up gardens upon their balconies, within their estates and their home gardens and compounds. The private sector has already made a contribution of more than 250,000 starter kits, and we want to welcome more partners to come on board as we roll out this national campaign on adoption of healthy diets. Two, reduction of food loss and wastage. The ministry is calling national attention to the issue of food loss and wastage. Earlier this month, we released guidelines and protocols to facilitate the supply chain actors in maintaining a steady flow of food to markets all across the country. We have, however, continued to receive numerous complaints from farmers and vendors who have not been able to easily access markets or their farms, and we are working with the relevant stakeholders to find a solution to this. We thank the public for always constantly reaching out to raise a red flag when they are stuck through our hotline. Our hotline is good to note our hotline so that if anyone is stuck at this particular time, they can be able to call us and we are able to sort out the issue that they may be having. So our hotline is 0800724891. I'll repeat, 0800724891. Our teams are working round the clock to respond. We, however, would like to retaliate that the ministry is committed to ensuring that all the value chains in the agriculture sector fully comply with the set protocols. We would not like to see a scenario where our food supply chain becomes responsible for an upsurge of new infections. Therefore, we call upon our stakeholders to work with us to fix the emerging issues, and especially our police and public health enforcement officers to take a more facilitative as opposed to a more punitive approach when handling our food transporters and vendors. Three, availability of food throughout the pandemic and afterwards. Ladies and gentlemen, we have put adequate measures to ensure the availability and accessibility of our national food staples. These range from cassava, maize, rice, wheat, beans, Irish potatoes, matoke, sorghum, millet, green grams, milk, meat, including poultry and fish, and local vegetables. We are closely monitoring the status of our farms and the market flows, and we will continue to update you on this issue. We understand the anxiety that many Kenyans have around food matters, and we want to take this opportunity to reassure you that the Food Security War Room will continue to monitor and swiftly respond to any challenges that may be forthcoming. Ladies and gentlemen, the Kenyan farmer is one of the most important people today. It is the farmer we are depending on to go to the farm and continue producing food while we stay safe at home. I would like to call upon the nation to celebrate our heroes today and even beyond for this important work that they continue to do to ensure our food and nutrition security during the global pandemic. Our agriculture economy will also be pivotal to our national economic recovery beyond COVID-19. This is why we will be using this opportunity to engage our young people, that is our youth, to join the agricultural workforce, bringing the innovations and talents to assist in transforming this crucial sector. We encourage parents to begin teaching their children during this period when they're at home to have a better appreciation of where their food comes from. They should also be encouraged to play an active role in setting up these kitchen gardens that we are about to establish. Finally, I would like to thank the Ministry of Health for its continued efforts and state that the Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Livestock and Cooperatives is fully committed to play its role towards flattening the curve. Thank you.